As if driving 8 hours north to visit your mother weren't torture enough, you have to go and get us lost. On the only road that doesn't have a signal.
Then use the map.
I pay AT&T $150 a month so they can do it for me. And your precious map companies use the same info as Google, it's just updated less frequently.
If they worked half the time, that would be great. But you have no reception, so you must use this map. And you're completely wrong about Google. They buy all their data from geological records funded by map companies.
Have you ever seen a Rand McNally car circling our block with cameras on top of it? Didn't think so.
That actually has nothing to do with road layout. That is completely for street view.
You just make this up on the spot, don't you?
It's like arguing with a little kid with you. It's very tedious. You hear nothing that I say. You're making this trip as boring and predictable as everything else we ever do.
Please, boring and predictable, moi.
Yesterday, it was you who made an event out of not putting the remote back in its cubby, wasn't it?
It's called a remote, buddy, Dan, and it's from SkyMall. And it's not being predictable, it's just being tired. And which of us is it that's eaten the exact same breakfast and gone to the same dead-end job and watched the exact same reruns of Seinfeld every night at 6 p.m. for the past 3 years? That's boring and predictable.
You want me to be a little bit less predictable, Janie? All right.
Oh, please, are you gonna ask this loser for directions?
Shut up. I'm trying to prove a point here. What? I'll die before those nasty hands touch my leather. No offense.
You're welcome.
You know, Janie, I don't think you've ever done anything this spontaneous, huh?
Excuse me? Did you completely forget about the drifter I picked up back on March 22nd?
That was March 23rd at 7 p.m. And that does not count. You trailed him for 15 days and you knew his mother's maiden name.
Well, that's a lot more spontaneous than trailing him for 28 days.
That's
boring.
Not fair! You know I can't break lunar cycle!
More soap?
No.
No! Let's see how boring you really are, Janie. Repeat, March 23rd. 6 foot tall, blonde hair. April 16th, 6 foot tall, blonde hair. May 13th, 6 foot tall, blonde hair!
I told you about the dream I had when I was 8 where I was raped by a Malibu Ken doll. All of your Vicks look 13 and have a shaved vagina.
That's purely coincidental. You know that.
What about the time you shaved it afterward? How do you think that makes me feel?
Well, regardless, we both know I am the more spontaneous one.
All right, well, if you're so spontaneous, why don't you bring down your own form of Zodiac justice on the Neanderthal in the backseat?
What do you think I am? Afraid or something? You think I care if the next crescent moon is 6 hours, 7 days away? Or that the nearest preschool was back in Bakersfield somewhere? I don't care. Look, this is your argument. You should be the one who's exercising her demented Freudian escapades all over the backseat.
Well, I would in a heartbeat. Despite the fact that his complexion is less than plastic and his cuticles haven't been manicured in months. But it's your point to prove, Mr. Spontaneous, so here, let me help you. Here is your spontaneous ceremonial kit. The same one you not so predictably disinfect weekly.
Look, Jane, the last thing you want when you're bleeding someone dry for 28 days is a tetanus infection, so excuse me. Yeah, sometimes I disinfect. Anyway, it's a lot more messy and daring than your trusted fresh needle and hazardous waste cleanup kit.
Well, pardon me. Have some empathy, Dan. The last thing I would want with cyanide pumping through my veins is HIV.
I knew you weren't gonna do it.
Well, I don't see you making a move. Or is he a little too old and a little too male for your taste?
Don't tempt me, Jane. I'll kill this fucker good.
Like Superman? You'll kill him well, dear. No! Oh my god. Oh. I'm so sorry. I wanted to be... Oh! Oh. You are my Malibu Kindle.
You have a shaved vagina.